A pipeline is typically a control spreadsheet of some nature, where on the left-hand side we have who it is we are looking to bring value to extra support to. Then the grade that we give to them. It doesn't matter how you grade, that's your thing, I don't prescribe on grades. Then the service or services or support that you wish to bring to the table. Then the value that you believe can be received as a result of that. Ignore the middle part for now, I'll come back to it in a second. The decision as to when you believe this business can take a decision as to whether to join you or not, and what has to happen next to make this happen. What's that middle bit? I said, right, each letter of the accounts mnemonic stands for a question that you would ask yourself after you've met a prospective client or after you've met an existing client about new opportunities. But the A would be, do we have the answer? Can we solve their problems? It's a binary question. It's either a 10 or a 0. There's no in between. Then ask yourself if they can afford you. The first C stands for cash. Have you got any evidence to show that they can fund this? The second C is convince. Is there anybody else we need to convince beyond who we've met with in order to reach a positive conclusion? The O is for objections. Do we see any major objections getting in our way? The U is simply undertake. Is this a piece of work we want to undertake, or is it another pain in the backside client that we do not want? We've got enough of those already. You might want to put the price up if you don't want to undertake the work. The N, necessity. This is the most commonly confused one. Not do we see the need for them to change, but do they see the need or urgency for them to change? If we cannot create, or if there's not already present, urgency within the prospect, this timescale for conversion is a long one, because there's no compelling reason to do anything at any time. The T, it stands for timing. In other words, have you got the timing of the next meeting with them in the diary? And generally we don't. We have, they're gonna email us, we're gonna email them, I said I'd call them next week, they're gonna send me books and records, and all of these things never actually occur. Your S, finally at the end, is signatory, because there are situations where people can make decisions, but somebody externally, an owner or major shareholder, has to sign off on something. Decision is taken, you've got the work, but somebody else has got to ratify.